What I normally do is if I'm going to work, I turn my TV on, I put a movie on, and I in my living room, I'll just put it on. I don't watch it, mind you. I just don't watch it. Maybe I put it on for my cat, I guess. Wasn't going to be an artist or anything like that. I started taking an art class. I didn't know what to expect, I guess. Our classes would be 4 hours long. And I'd go in there and I mean, I would enjoy every minute of it. And the other people in the class would just be like, well, they would draw for an hour and just be tired. And I'd leave there and I'd go home and I'd be drawing some more. Rembrandt used to believe himself as like a piece of moss growing on a piece of bark in the middle of an ocean, floating in the middle of a storm. And it kind of says where you need to go as an artist and what you need to be as an artist. You can't be somebody who has your boat tied up to the dock all the time, and you have to take on an artistic license, and you have to go to areas, you have to go to places that other people don't go to. When I was up at Fort Kent, I got in a car accident in 2003. And I didn't think anything of it. I got a herniated disc from it. And eventually, I had to go to the hospital because I had a brain injury and PTSD from it. So I ended up in a hospital in Kennebunk for 6 months. And I just didn't know what to do, didn't know how to talk or anything like that. I'd have spasticity, I'd be shaking. In the hospital, all I went down there with was with like art materials. And I would like, I didn't want a TV, I didn't want anything like that. I just had there was an art store down the road, and I would just like draw, like, and I would draw out the window. There would be like a barn out the window, and I would draw this barn out the window, and I would draw with my like people that were living there. And it was, I remember one person there, he couldn't talk or anything like that, and we would draw together, and it was pretty cool, I like that. I think it meant a lot to him too. It's meant a lot to me too. And I mean, you look at my work before my accident, and you look at my work now, it's night and day. Cause like, I'll be thinking of something, I'll be working, and then I'm just able to change it just like that and go in a different direction. Is your memories, and your future is your imagination. So when you're a kid, you don't have your memories to rely on. You only have your imagination. So that's when you get older, you start dealing more with your memory. And you start remembering how things are done and how to do it. And you stop painting as good. And so that's why you have to, as you grow older, the things that you learn aren't always right. What you know will change. I met the artist Jean Pilk, and I ended up going down to her studio. And that was something else. Like, that was really interesting. I've never met somebody like that before. I brought like 6 works down there with me. And she I don't think she knew what to expect, really. And She looks at my art. She looked at my self-portrait that I did of when I was a baby in my living room, and she's up in age when she's doing this, and she gets right down to my art, where she gets on her knees, gets right on the floor, and sits with all of my art. And I was like, I think she might like it or something. And like, she's like, wow, you know, and like, probably like 5-10 minutes go by. And she's like, you mind? She's like, I think you're one of the best portrait artists I've ever met. And I was like, I didn't know what to say. And I was, obviously I felt good. And so, we ended up eating dinner with her, and, probably like, I don't know, 30, 40 minutes go by. And she's looking at me. We're talking about art and stuff like that. And she's like, she points at me, I believe. And she looks at me. And she's like, I want you to remember this. And she's like, she looks at me. She's like, you're going to be famous one of these days. And I was like, I don't know what to say, you know. But she's like, I don't know. I don't know about that. I was like, I don't know about that. I don't think so. but no, something like that makes you feel good, because it's when it's your mother or something like that that says it. Everybody's mother says that to you. But when it's somebody who's made it, it's like, it makes you feel good, I guess, right? People tell you, you know, you can't make it, or wherever you want to get in life. And the people who tell you that are the people who haven't made it themselves. And that's what I started noticing. And I noticing how true it is. Because some of the people that I was working with who told me that I wasn't a good artist, they weren't showing me their own artwork as examples to, you know, to me for to learn off of. And a lot of things that I learned off them, they didn't have a lot of substance to it. You have to be careful on who you work with and who you, you know, because it can change you and who you feed yourself off of. But no, I've been liking, George Kondo's artwork. She's not famous or anything. I like Zoe Rose Schwartz. She makes beautiful artwork. I think she's on Instagram. Definitely influenced by her art. I'll lose my direction sometimes with what I'm thinking. And then all of a sudden when I'm working, I lose what I'm drawing. I forget almost what's going on, and I'm allowed to change gears into something different. And I can do it a lot easier. And I mean, but there comes a point where I decide to say to myself, where I ruin the painting. I make it to a certain area that I kind of ruin it. And then like, I'll go, and then it brings me to an area that I wouldn't have thought of, that I wouldn't have like been there before. And I couldn't imagine, like, and it comes to a point when it comes to these points in my artwork, I mean, I take a break. I just, you know, I step back and stuff like that. But, you know, don't get in there with your wrist and just like this. Draw with your shoulder and breathe when you're painting. Breathe in, breathe out. You get to areas in your painting where you'd be like, ooh, I don't want to mess up. And then I get there, don't get me wrong. And you get to have to realize that it's just a painting. Just breathe.